Janine Edwards will work the sidelines for us. Let's check in with her right now. Janine.
Well, Mike, it's got to be hard to be the guy who follows the record-setting guy. Navy quarterback Chris Proctor has faced the inevitable comparisons to Ricky Dobbs. Proctor told me before tonight's game, hey, I've been an underdog my whole life. I've had to learn to thrive on this. Well, Navy coaches sat him down recently, and they said, son, your chance will come. Look at Brett Favre and Aaron Rodgers and how Rodgers has made the most of the opportunity he's finally gotten. He said, just be yourself and make your mark on this program. And that he is. He has got their offense humming. And, Mike, don't think South Carolina hasn't taken notice.
All right, Janine, thanks very much. Navy coach Ken Niumatalolo can coach at Navy as long as he wants. He's averaging 9 wins a year. His system is perfect for the academy, and he is unbeaten against Army. He's got a job for life if he wants it.
This is the kind of game the Navy football players say, we came here, we understand why we're on their schedule. This motivates us. We want to make them pay for putting us on their schedule.
People used to schedule them for that reason, not anymore. Steve Spurrier may have his most talented team in his 7th year, but he is quick to point out the difference between performance and potential. His defense has to step up for him tonight. These teams played a huge game in the distant past. In 1984, South Carolina was undefeated. They were number 2 in the country. They traveled to play Navy with a score tied at 7. The midshipmen scored 31 unanswered points. On the defensive side of the ball, Navy was led by Eric Rutherford, who had 4 sacks. In the third quarter, midshipman Rich Klaus added a 53-yard touchdown run in a 38-21 Navy upset win over number 2 South Carolina. South Carolina ranked 10th this week, and Navy, if they run their offense and get a couple of turnovers, is capable of beating anybody. They have proven it. South Carolina won the toss, deferred. Navy will get the ball to start the game. Jay Wooten to kick it off. Marcus Thomas is back with Bo Snelson. And they are fired up in Columbia. Three of Wooten's 17 kickoffs have gone for touchbacks. Thomas from the 9. Across the 25, still fights for yardage, gets it out to the 28-yard line. Navy quarterback Chris Proctor, as Janine said, waited 4 years for his chance to start. As Ricky Dobbs set all kinds of records, he has certainly done the job so far in his brief starting session, rushing for almost 100 yards a game. And watch his speed. He may be the fastest quarterback in the history of the Naval Academy.
I like his management ability. He always makes the right decisions on who should get the football in his triple option. That's been his trademark to this point.
Proctor on the keeper. Out to the 33, and let's take a look at our Chick-fil-A impact players.
Alexander Teach is a fullback, number 39, and in this offense, it all starts inside. If Teach is getting after it, they're having a good game. He's a power guy, but he also has some finesse. Melvin Ingram on defense. Last week for South Carolina, you see what he did against Georgia. And Devontae Holloman, he has to have a great game. He's been moved to the safety in the secondary to help bring up some pressure from that spot.
Proctor keeps again, crosses the 35 to the 36, the yard line to make is the 38. And Antonio Allen, who is a tackling machine for South Carolina, was in on the stop. He had 16 tackles against Georgia a week ago.
This is the down and distance, though, that Navy likes to be in. 3rd and 2 is real makeable for them. And South Carolina has given up 45% on third down and conversions by the opponent. They've not been good in this scenario.
Staten and Snelson are in at the wingbacks. Teach. Boy, he didn't make it initially and then drove forward after he was hit. That's one of the things they love about Alexander Teach.
And I told you that he's not just a power guy. He has some finesse to him. Was an outstanding high school runner down in Caney Creek outside Conroe in Texas. And so that athletic ability to go with the power that he possesses is a good, strong weapon on the inside.
Staten remains in the game. There's the toss to Darius Staten. He'll get a couple before he's taken down at the sideline. Craig, this offense so tough for the defensive team to get ready for in 1 week.
And right there, Mike, I was watching at the top of the field. The wide receivers for this offense must be outstanding blockers. That means that South Carolina's corner, the perimeter of this game, they've got to get off those blocks. But many times they get caught watching in the backfield. We'll see if their eyes put them to sleep.
Keep an eye on John Howell, number 33. When he has touched it this year, he has done a lot of good things with it, averaging over 25 yards a carry. Quarterback keeper, about a yard shy of the first down, setting up another perfect third down yardage for Navy. Melvin Ingram was in on the tackle. Proctor already was 15 yards.
Now, third downs, I mentioned it. It is such a big part of a football game. To me, the most important play of a game. And this season, they have not improved off of a poor season last year.
They do a lot of this, and then they look to the sideline to get the play. They put that man in motion to see how the defense is going to adjust.
They'll go to the right. They're looking at numbers. They're trying to go to where there's an advantage in the numbers game.
Howell hitting the backfield and coming up from his spur position was Antonio Allen to mess up the timing on the play. They did a really nice job covering that. And then Quarles, number 99, came in and cleaned up the tackle.
Well, you have to have good responsibility on the inside, but there wasn't any pressure on the end man of the line of scrimmage. He went straight to the pitch back. That look, took away the outside game.
Look at Navy. They're showing they're going to go for it on fourth down. Instead, Proctor will drop back and quick kick. And they'll down it outside the 20. G.G. Green downfield to cover on special teams. South Carolina quarterback Stephen Garcia's career has had more twists and turns than a good detective novel. But on the field, he is still one of the best ever at South Carolina. Number 3 all-time in touchdown passes and in yards passing.
Not sure that Garcia has liked the chapters that Spurrier has written in his novel.
No.
But he's got the ability. He's not been accurate this year. This team's only had 21 of 51 completions on passes. That's just not a Spurrier offense.
Lattimore, what a cut! Marcus Lattimore showing you it's not just power. He's got the ability to make people miss. 31 yards on his first carry.
This is a power offense. This is a powerful football team. Inside, you're only going to have 3 guys on the line of scrimmage. That's a big bubble, a void. Any good runner loves to have the bubbles of a defense. You know, linebackers off the line of scrimmage. You got to get up and you got to meet Lattimore. Can't let him get going.
Garcia throws the quick out to Jason Barnes. And Jason Barnes will have another first down for South Carolina. Lattimore at 232 pounds outweighs 8 of the 11 Navy defenders.
Okay, and here's a problem for Navy. They have 3 linebackers who are out of this game. They've had to move one, the backup at Rover, who is Trevez Bush. He's only 192 pounds. He's playing linebacker, a very light unit.
Lattimore drilled as he got to the line of scrimmage that time. Jamel Dobbs with a big hit. Let's take a look at our impact players brought to you by Chick-fil-A.
I think it's easy to say every game he's going to be a Lattimore as an impact player, but let's watch what he does away from the ball. When he doesn't carry the football, what he does. Alshon Jeffries on the outside, 10 receptions coming into this game. He's a guy that can catch 10 balls in any single half. And then the other impact that we didn't get to show you there is the defense. We're going to call it the Naval Fleet. The Naval Fleet must show up today to stop Marcus Lattimore.
Alshon Jeffery, barring injury, is going to break every South Carolina and SEC record there is. Garcia deep downfield, just overthrown. Ace Sanders got his right hand on it, but couldn't pull it in. Garcia just a little strong.
And this is just one of those balls when you know that it's there and the play action and what they do and the flea flicker back to him. It is a ball that Garcia has to hit. That's the kind of throw that frustrates Steve Spurrier. He gets a play like that, someone behind the secondary, got to hit the home run when it's open.
Sean Lynch, the free safety, was beaten. Third down and 9. Garcia in the gun. 4 wide receivers, a 3-man rush by Navy. Garcia throws on the run and threw it horribly. Had Bruce Ellington wide open in the flat. He was about 5 yards away from him, and he missed him by 3 yards.
Yeah, now here's what's really important. Now watch right here, the back out into the zone. Understanding what the down and distance is gives a little different look. So the crossing route is interrupted by the fire zone. The defensive lineman who dropped right back in there made the pass go high.
Boy. Fourth down, South Carolina not showing any sign of a kick. They're in that no man's land about the 35-yard line. Garcia, again, badly overthrown. Garcia coming into this game was completing only 45% of his passes. In this day and age of college football, that is very, very low. In fact, he didn't start the first game of the year. That was Connor Shaw.
Football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Welcome back to the SEC on ESPN. Each team has had the ball once, and we are scoreless. Navy will now start at its own 35-yard line, 9:23 to go first quarter. People still buzzing about the 2 consecutive passes that Garcia missed.
Not sure buzzing would be the appropriate thing for what Steve Spurrier's thinking right now, but he is absolutely not happy with those throws. And he told us in our meetings this week, look, it is what it is. He's not going to go to Connor Shaw. At least he said he wasn't going to go to Connor Shaw, the backup quarterback. He knows he's a running quarterback right now, and he's got to give it to Lattimore, so we'll see the adjustments they make.
You saw the success that Navy has had in the first quarter, and there's the toss to G.G. Green, and he is into South Carolina territory. This offense can burn you with a big play anytime. That was a gain of 30, the longest run of the year for the junior from Columbia, South Carolina, the hometown product.
Look at all of the jerseys go to the middle of the field. They got sucked in to the fullback dive. You have to be responsible for your guy and your guy only.
Proctor on the keeper knocked out of bounds as he got to the 30.
Mike, we'll talk about gap responsibility throughout this ball game in South Carolina's defense. Ellis Johnson knew this was going to be a headache of a football game. This offense averages 400 yards a game on the ground. I don't care who they play against, they're going to be successful because they're disciplined. They plug new guys in. You got a new quarterback, Chris Proctor, as Janine said earlier in this deal. He's taking the reins. This is his football team. And his explosiveness with his legs at some point will show the South Carolina defense there's another weapon back there.
Howell and Stuckel are the halfbacks. That's the fullback, Alexander Teach, the senior from Conroe, Texas, who goes up the middle. Aldrick Fordham made the tackle.
These backs on Navy's football team, you see the wings, they're called A-backs. And they have to be great runners, they have to be great receivers, they have to be great blockers. See them on the wings back there, and they never know who's going to get the ball. Now the play is being called in. They're looking at the defense.
Another great down and distance for Navy. It's third and two. Howell got the speed. Touchdown. Stuckel threw him a block. And Howell went 27 yards to the house. Defensively, if you make a mistake against Navy, it's over.
We're going to draw up for you here in just a little bit and show you what those A-backs do for each other. One running, one blocking, and the execution and the perfection of this offense.
John Teague, who has struggled earlier in the year with point after attempts, hits this one. He is now 9 out of 12, and the Naval Academy jumps on top against number 10, South Carolina. South Carolina pep rally held yesterday on the Horseshoe on campus.
Oh, we gotta keep it up, boys.
Teague will kick to Ellington. And the people here are just stunned. It really shouldn't be. Navy's averaging 9 wins a year forever, it seems.
But they're still using that personal motivation, like everyone's putting them out there and wants to play them because they think they're going to smack them. And that's what drives this program. They're looking to step up and show the guys across the way, hey, you made a mistake.
Unusual alignment, Navy bunching up its kick coverage. Ellington, who is also the point guard on the basketball team, drives up close to the 30-yard line.
All right, let's go back and look at the execution on this play. It's timing and deception. Look at your A-back. Watch the receiver come out and then come to the inside. He catches the safety asleep. He's looking in the backfield. The timing of it to come off, they trade off who they're blocking with. That is why defensively during practice week, you can't really replicate as a scout squad what you're about to go against in a ball game.
You know, on that run, not only was he untouched by human hands, I don't know if anybody got close enough to hit him with a dodgeball. Garcia, who has missed miserably on his last two throws, comes up here and hits Jason Barnes. And our first chance to check into the studio with Wendy Nix. Wendy.
Mike, thank you. It's a Taco Bell studio update. Tennessee took a red-hot Tyler Bray into the swamp, but this has been all about the Gators from the get-go. John Brantley to Chris Rainey, 83 yards later, and it is 30-13 Florida over Tennessee.
Thank you, Wendy. South Carolina goes back to work with Ellington.
You notice that Steve Spurrier came right back with the pass. He's got to get Steven Garcia in a rhythm. And he's going right back to some high percentage throws over the middle and then the screen.
Well, you have to feel that throughout his career, he has been as connected to quarterbacks as anybody conceivably could have been as a Heisman winner himself at Florida. Lattimore. You almost expect anything less than a 20-yard run is a disappointment for Lattimore.
I can only tell you that when you're going as a great runner like he is with the power and the speed and the vision, and you only have three guys on that line of scrimmage, and there's that soft bubble that allows your lineman to get out on them, and it allows a soft spot for him to get to, he's going to hurt you.
Three carries, 51 yards, not a bad start for Marcus Lattimore.
Mike, that is an example for me of what makes Lattimore so dangerous. He pushes right at the line of scrimmage, right behind the right guard, and as everyone sucks right into it, he has the ability to stop and cut left and then go again full speed. That's unique for a guy who's a power back.
Came in averaging 144 yards a game. That's seventh best in the nation. And he's just not a big guy who runs over people. Very little subtle cut on that last play that set up a block. I mean, he's a very smart kid. He knows what he's doing out there.
I'll tell you the other thing is, too, watch his shoulder pads. His shoulder pads are always over his feet in forward. That way he's not slipping and cutting on those back cleats on his heel. That allows him to make those dramatic cuts.
Another first down, South Carolina. Lattimore. Close to the six. That'll bring up a second and three, which opens up the playbook for Steve Spurrier. Sean Lynch, the free safety, made the tackle. This is a good response for South Carolina after Navy burned them for seven.
Well, what it's doing, too, is Ellis Johnson's over trying to get his defense coached up before they have to take the field again to figure out where the blocks are coming from.
The only wide receiver, Alshon Jeffrey, to the right. They give it to Lattimore instead, driving the pile forward. Touchdown.
Mike, you pointed out earlier that at 230 pounds, Lattimore is heavier than most of the defenders on the Navy football team. And the fact that he plays with a flat back and allows that power of that legs to get him to the end zone. Unless you get down to his legs tackling, you're not going to stop him.
Seven plays, 71 yards on that drive. Most of it eaten up by Lattimore, who is now 7 for 82 in the first quarter. Wooten converts. We're tied at seven. This week on ESPN's Monday Night Football, second-year quarterback Sam Bradford will lead the Rams into MetLife Stadium. They'll face Eli Manning and the Giants. Rams-Giants, Monday Night Football, 8:30 Eastern. Also streaming live on WatchESPN.com and the Watch ESPN app. Coverage begins at 7 with Monday Night Countdown, served by Applebee's.
I get the feeling Ole Miss would like to have another Manning come along about now. I think Vanderbilt shut them out today.
That's amazing. I don't think there are any more. Marcus Thomas driven all the way back to the goal line. A seam up the middle. Tripped up as he crossed the 20 to about the 23. Here's Wendy Nix.
Mike, thank you. A pretty good day at the office for Russell Wilson. 23 of 32, 347 yards, three touchdowns, including this one to Nick Toon, the 16-yard connection. It's 49-7 over Northern Illinois. Also, Notre Dame after that tough loss last week, 28-13 over Michigan State.
All right, Wendy, thanks very much. Bo Snelson and G.G. Green are the running backs. Nelson also has good speed across the 30, picks up about 8. G.G. Green threw him a good block, and we check in with Janine Edwards.
Well, Mike and Craig, you may notice that South Carolina has shuffled their linebackers for this series, and they had shuffled their defensive backs for this game, saying that they needed more physical safeties that could fight through blocks. And they've been told before they headed out, they've got to be quicker and more deliberate. And don't forget, they practiced this week without a ball to speed up their reps.
Second and a yard. Proctor on the toss. And it's pretty obvious as Green gets the first down that South Carolina is keying on Proctor. He's the guy they seem to fear the most right now in that option.
You can't key on any one individual defensively against the triple option. You have your job and your responsibility. If you're watching Proctor, then you're going to be flat-footed, and the next thing you know, some of these A-backs or wide receivers will be blocking you to the ground.
Navy averaging, as you saw, over 10 yards a carry on first down. You're going to win every time if you do that. Little toss sweep to Staten. And Staten is driven out of bounds by Reginald Bowens.
What I found in watching over the years, Navy and Georgia Tech, where Paul Johnson is now, who used to be at Navy, these offenses do well early on, and defenses, as the game goes along, they're able to feel it a little bit better. Because in practice, you can't replicate the speed and the execution, the perfection of what you're about to face on a Saturday afternoon or evening.
Yeah. Bruce Andrews, number 80, is in as a wide receiver, and Staten goes into the slot. This is Howell with that great speed. Can't use it that time. Taking down at the 48-yard line. They need to reach almost the 48-yard line on the other side of midfield.
Now you're starting to see the secondary as they're being blocked, using their hands better and fighting off. Stephon Gilmore that time, he did a nice job of forcing the play back inside and not allowing himself to be leveraged and losing containment.
Teach was the only one left in the backfield, and Proctor to throw his first pass, and throws complete to Bruce Andrews, who makes his first catch of the year. For Proctor, only the 15th pass he has thrown in three games, and only the 8th one that he has completed.
A lot of activity going on in the secondary, and again, these guys expecting to be blocked, and then the play action, and they do a nice job of just settling, understanding where he's supposed to be. Andrews gets up, finds the soft spot and settles, waits on the ball.
Green picks up about 6. So it's a 2nd and 4 coming for Navy. They just put so much pressure on you on the outside, particularly.
Yeah, you add in a pass every 2 or 3 series just to change it up. They're not going to throw it at you many times.
I thought you were going to say every 2 or 3 games.
It might feel like that. You don't need it that often, and Chris Proctor showing that he has an arm capable of being accurate with him. South Carolina's defense is going to figure out some of these calls eventually. They got to pay attention and start learning on the field, be mentally talented.
Staten and Howell are the wingbacks, and they give to Teach, and Teach has a first down at the 34-yard line. Devin Taylor makes the tackle, and for an offense, particularly this offense, it's a numbers game. If you show 6 to one side of the field, they try to run to the other. If you show 6 then to the other side of the field, they try to run to the first one.
Very, very good at managing this offense is Chris Proctor. And this isn't about a smash mouth running game. Heck, Navy's offensive line is probably 25 or 30 pounds less than South Carolina's D line.
Teach again. Maybe 5 yards on first down. Just a simple, the simplest play there is, a dive play by the fullback.
Defenses who've been successful in slowing down the triple option, in my mind, have been the defenses who have the defensive tackles who push back the guards and the line of scrimmage and force the quarterback to bow, get deeper, and it disrupts the rhythm.
That's not happening right now, is it?
No, they're receiving. That defensive line is just receiving. I think right now South Carolina's eyes, they're playing way too many games with the eyes. They don't have a feel. They're not playing downhill.
Snelson and Green on the wing. Quarterback keeper for maybe 4 for Chris Proctor.
Well, another 3rd and short, and on 3rd downs in this game, Navy 75% at this point in time.
We finished the first quarter in Columbia. It's been a good one. Navy and number 10 South Carolina tied at 7 apiece. Seen exactly what we expected to see out of both ball clubs so far. Proctor on the keeper, spun down at the 15-yard line. Teach with a good block in front of him. First down, Navy.
One of my favorite plays, the most successful plays for the triple option, is the midline quarterback keep. He fakes to the fullback and follows him right back up in there. He allows that fullback to become his blocker, and it's a real successful play. Very hard to defend that.
11th play of the drive coming. G.G. Green. Nice cut. Green down to the five. If he's inside the five, it's another first down. 10 yards a clip every first down, it seems.
They're trying to figure out on defense how to get to the pitch back. They've done a poor job of that. The alley on the outside, you see number four, the block going. No one's filling that alley. No one's getting up in there to meet the ball carrier. That's because South Carolina's defense right now still hasn't got a feel for this offense. They don't know where the blocks are coming from.
Melvin Ingram, their outstanding defensive end, is being tended to in the locker room with some kind of an injury. We'll get an update as soon as possible from Janine. He was the National Defensive Player of the Year, or of the week last week, with two touchdowns. Proctor into the end zone, touchdown Navy.
That circle that I had right there is Jadeveon Clowney, the great true freshman, lots of potential. He was in there for Ingram, who's in the locker room, and you saw the push over on that side. They pushed him back.
Right in front of the midshipman who made the trip down here. 12 plays, 77 yards, took almost 6 minutes off the clock. That's the other thing about this offense. It lets their defense rest, and it just wears down the opposition.
It tests the patience of your opponent. South Carolina has to understand that this is going to be a battle of a football game. Do your job, get ready. The chase for the Sprint Cup begins with Jimmy Johnson eyeing his sixth straight title, while regular season points leader Kyle Busch and four-time NASCAR champion Jeff Gordon look to knock him off. The chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup starts with the Geico 400 at Chicago. Coverage begins tomorrow at 1 Eastern on ESPN with NASCAR Countdown, presented by Napa.
Thank you, Craig.
Don't get in a habit of that. I know you're fighting the cold and
fighting a sore throat.
Being a teammate today.
Very nicely done. Navy has already rushed for 154 yards. I mean, South Carolina's defense has barely slowed them down, let alone stopped them. But now Lattimore will get another crack at it. And he had 5 carries for 50 yards on the last drive. Ellington. He'll take a knee and they'll go from the 20. Let's check in with Wendy.
Mike, thank you very much. If LaMichael James has a good day, typically Oregon does as well. Here is a 90-yard touchdown run for James. He also had a 50-yard touchdown run, 204 yards on 12 carries. Oregon put all kind of points on the board, 56-7, and another service academy winning today, Army over Northwestern.
Way to go for the Black Knights. To me, college football is much better when the service academies have competitive winning teams. Lattimore this time only gets about 3. That's a huge victory for the Navy defense. Matt Brewer, one of the inside linebackers, makes the stop.
Lattimore in this ball game, that's a pretty good average right there. And in my math class, guys, I think that's over 10 per carry. Last week I messed up on math, and y'all won't leave me alone with that.
Lattimore again. Well, when the errors are so egregious that you can't miss them. Lattimore, 7 straight carries for the Gamecocks offense.
Well, as Steve Spurrier said, you know what? You give it to the best player on the field, and that's Marcus Lattimore. And these third and fours have not been really good for South Carolina at this point, but they've got to convert on these.
Garcia in the shotgun. Fakes it to Lattimore and keeps, and Garcia, with second effort, dives ahead to get a first down.
Well, the old James game, the EA Sports folks have given us a shot again at showing you what makes Garcia really effective, and that is his ability to run. He's like a fullback. And when you put Lattimore in front of him blocking, who is a really good blocker, that's an added dimension to this offense that makes it hard to defend.
Yeah, Lattimore's not just a ball carrier. He is a do-everything back with a great attitude about playing this game. A little flanker screen to Barnes. Barnes. And that's another good thing that helps Garcia. An easy throw there to maybe get him back in rhythm.
Absolutely. Now, if you're Navy, you're patient. Their defensive coordinator, Buddy Green's been here 10 years now. And he understands what he has. Keep him in front of you. Bend, don't break. So you're not going to see a lot of risk-taking coming from Buddy Green.
Another quick out, this one to Ace Sanders. You got to be pretty good if your nickname is Ace, don't you?
Or fake it real well.
Excellent speed last year. He had 25 catches. David Sperry, the corner on that side, made a solid tackle.
Now Sanders had the punt return touchdown versus East Carolina in the opening game of the season, which was a first in a long time. They don't do many of the punt return, kick returns for touchdowns at South Carolina under Spurrier.
Now this is going to be an interesting call. One of the Navy defensive linemen, looked like Jared Marks, jumped offside, but he's got the opportunity, to my understanding, to get
offside. Defense number 91, 5 yards, still first down.
And it looks like Terrence Campbell, a right guard, reaches out and touched him.
And he drew him over there, though.
Oh, I don't think there was any drawing at all. He was trying to make sure the flag was thrown. I don't think you can do that. But if you can't, he certainly got away with it.
Well, I know this. It's a rare Navy mistake. They don't make many penalties.
Lattimore hitting the backfield. And for one of the few times, a negative play for Lattimore, but somebody may have grabbed a face mask as Lattimore went down in a pile. Jabari Tawani made the tackle. No, it's a hold. Tawani by
holding
far their best
offense
defensive
number 73,
lineman.
10 yards previous spot. Still first down.
Well, there's a nickel defense here at Navy today. They're going with a lot of defensive backs. But again, I think the thing that's different on this particular play there was, look, you've got four now on the line of scrimmage. These are the bubbles that I was talking about earlier. Those are easy to run at. And when you eliminate one of those bubbles and you put him up on the line of scrimmage, it's one less option for that tailback to get to.
Tawani was so good his first 2 years, the recruiters kept calling the Naval Academy and wanting him to transfer before he became an upperclassman. Garcia with all day to throw, still can't find anybody, and brought down from behind by Bri French, who was starting because they have so many injuries at outside linebacker. He is a 6'1", 205-pound junior. Gets a 3-yard loss on the sack because he would not give up.
Navy's defense, Buddy Green, does a nice job of changing it up. You see the drop, the fire zone. You put someone else in that coverage there. It's a different man dropping that time. And it's somehow messing with the eyes of Garcia. And I guarantee you, Spurrier saying, throw the ball away. Get rid of the thing.
South Carolina, 1 out of 2 on third down. Garcia deep down the sideline, and it's complete to the 25-yard line. Perfect throw to Nick Jones. And a good play by Garcia. That ought to give him some confidence.
Absolutely. You know what? That was one of those throws that says, okay, hey, coach, this is why you've named me your starter. It'll pick him up, and it will, Mike, give him some confidence. But you notice how he got up. He stepped up in the pocket. When he stepped up, it put pressure on that secondary, and it opened up his receiver.
It's only the second catch Jones has made this year, as the passing game has not been very explosive. Again, it was Lattimore, this time taken down by Trevez Bush.
A methodical approach here by South Carolina when they're throwing the ball just enough on the last play to make that defense think about it. You know, it can't all be Lattimore. And I think they also need to, at South Carolina, to continue to use Steven Garcia and his running ability. Just occasionally mix it up.
Justice Cunningham, 87, in the backfield right now. Lattimore off the right side. Garcia out in front trying to throw him a block. And Lattimore is down to the 5. He is already over 100 yards in this ball game. Came in averaging 144.
Navy's not able to get off the block. South Carolina's offensive linemen are swallowing them up. And if you can't get to the legs of number 21, you're not going to bring him down.
What back-to-back quarters Lattimore has had. 94 in the fourth quarter against Georgia last week in a do-or-die situation for his ball club. And 110 yards in this one. Lattimore again. 1 point away from the tie. This guy could end up with a couple of Heisman trophies in his closet.
If they win 10 games this season, he will be in New York City as a candidate for the Heisman Trophy. Because those 10 wins will come as a direct result of his legs.
12 carries, 115 yards for Lattimore. Tied at 14 with 8:05 to go in the first half. The defenses have to be thinking, you know, if we get a stop, our offense might score every time. George Rogers, what a beast he was in 1980 when he won the Heisman. Still holds the school rushing record, 5,204 yards. And Lattimore, should he stay 4 years, you would have to think he could have that record in his hip pocket. Look at those numbers. Fourth quarter at Georgia, 94. Tonight against Navy so far, 115 and two touchdowns.
He's a three and out guy. As a running back, as good as he is, what he will have proven in this conference, there's no reason for him to come back. You've only got so many carries as a ball carrier. Go ahead and get paid for it after his third year.
South Carolina overloads its kickoff team to the right, and they are going to go for the onside kick, but it's recovered by the Naval Academy, and now the officials are going to wave it off.
Prior to the kick, timeout, Navy.
Ooh, that's a good timeout, though, by Ken Niumatalolo, making sure that he had the right personnel over there for that. Makes you wonder what's for. Sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets. Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kicked. To date, Allstate has contributed more than $2.4 million in scholarship monies.
Craig, let me ask you about that onside kick. Was Steve Spurrier making a statement to his defense that you guys haven't stopped Navy, I want to get the ball back?
That's the only thing that it can be, because he wasn't trying to trick them. It wasn't one of those deals where you run up there and you hope to block and get the ball recovered. I think it's a statement. Navy was ready. I still admire Niumatalolo for making sure and calling timeout that there wasn't a mishap there. But, yeah, that's not a good message going to your defense.
Marcus Thomas deep as they kick it away this time. Thomas from the 10. For about the 21-yard line, and we check in with Wendy Nix. Wendy.
Mike, thank you. Washington taking a 6-game winning streak on the road to Nebraska, but they'll need to battle back to make it 7. Heath Price to James Johnson, a 52-yard connection. And now Washington trails by 13. It's 51-38 Nebraska.
All right, Wendy, let's see if the South Carolina defense can make any kind of an adjustment. G.G. Green will pick up about 3, and here's Janine Edwards.
Well, guys, yeah, and for a defense that Spurrier has been saying, you know, needs a pass rush, they definitely don't want to lose this guy, Melvin Ingram. He went to the locker room a little bit ago with a thigh contusion in his right leg. They put some extra padding in his leg. He stretched it out, and he's back on the field. And as for Navy's offense, well, their coaches were telling them, guys, don't get overconfident here. As we've seen, South Carolina could score at will. Just tend to your business.
All right, thanks, Janina. Melvin Ingram, called by his coaches perhaps the best athlete on this team. Teach bursts through the middle and takes it out to the 40 until he's ridden out of bounds by Stephon Gilmore. But Teach at 6 feet 217 is a very powerful runner.
Well, and you know, when you talk about responsibilities, watch what happens this time with Ingram. Watch how he's running. He is getting outside so hard, he ran past. He ran past that ball carrier, Teach, on the inside. You have to be disciplined inside out.
Gain of 17 on the last play.
Coaches told us when they run play action, they're going for the home run ball. That's one of those, if you buy just a little more time and float the ball, there's no safety back there. You've got a chance for the home run. Be patient. Understand you've got some green to work with.
Tough to be patient when you only throw the ball a handful of times, though, isn't it?
Okay, good point.
And he waited all those years for Ricky Dobbs to graduate the Naval Academy to get his chance.
South Carolina, this is the down and distance they want. Second and 10, second and 12. This is what Ellis Johnson's working for.
And they run Teach right up the middle, and Teach picks up 7, maybe 8 yards, which will bring up third and manageable again for the Naval Academy. When they're third and 2, it just opens up so many options for them.
Well, and coming into this game, South Carolina's weakness was on third down defense. They'd given up 45% conversions. Not a very good number. Tonight on third downs, it's been Navy at will trying to do whatever they wanted to do. They've been 4 out of 5. Watch the midline with the quarterback. Fake to the fullback, follow the fullback up into the hole.
Quarterback keeper and then the toss. And it's a first down. Good job by Bo Snelson to get outside. Snelson out of Pasadena, Texas.
I used to live in Pasadena, Texas when I was a little boy. This is just this again. This is great execution. You have to be mindful on defense that he will pull the ball and get it to the outside. They start setting you up with that fullback, fullback, fullback. Then he pulls the ball and he's on the perimeter before you know it.
Just for informational purposes, where is Pasadena?
Just out of South Houston. It's south of Houston.
Okay. Teach again. This time hit almost immediately and brought down by Fordham.
Matter of fact, you remember the movie Urban Cowboy?
Oh, sure.
And Mickey Gilley had a place there. We used to live in an apartment complex right next door to it, but it was a 5-man honky-tonk back then. My brother and I'd go bird hunting with pellet guns in the pasture. Pasadena's a good place.
Second down and call it 6. Clock running with 5:06 to go in the first half. Tie ball game in Columbia, South Carolina. Diggs is now in at fullback. Proctor tries to reverse his field. He'll come up a couple of yards shy of a first down. Another third down and short yardage situation for Navy. And they are probably in 4-down territory right here.
Well, again, at this point in the game, they're 5 of 6 on third down. If they can have positive yardage on it, there's no reason that they shouldn't go for it on fourth and short.
More like 3 yards and not 2. Howell on the toss, trying to get him outside with that speed, but South Carolina shows some speed of their own, and he'll be a couple of yards shy.
I'd go for it. You go for it here. Absolutely, because in South Carolina's mind, if they break serve, they're ahead.
Feels like that, doesn't it?
Yes. You're starting to see that inside out pressure, the speed of South Carolina's linebackers starting to move a little bit more.
And they will go on 4th and 2.
Numbers over here look a lot better.
Navy, second charge, timeout.
And we've got a timeout. Navy wants to talk about it with 3:38 to go in the first half. Welcome back to the SEC on ESPN. Navy with 195 yards rushing so far in this ballgame. They'd give anything for 2 more right now because it's 4th and 2.
Alexander Teach, the fullback, 7 carries, 42 yards. I'd give it to him in the middle.
Keeper. And Proctor is turned back by Devin Taylor, the all-SEC defensive end from a year ago. From the initial spot, he didn't get it.
Yeah, that's that midline quarterback keeper that is usually successful. South Carolina starting to get off blocks and make plays. Devin Taylor there, 98, came off and stopped the forward progress of the quarterback Proctor.
So a big lift for South Carolina as their defense holds after they had been pushed all over the field for the better part of a half. Now can Navy respond in the same way against South Carolina's offense?
Down here you got Alshon Jeffries. You got that guy that's one of the best in the country.
Garcia to Lattimore in the flat. Lattimore out to the 42-yard line. Whew. Yes, he is a good pass receiver. He's a good blocker. He's a brilliant runner. Picks up blitzes.
He likes the middle of the field tonight. 12 carries, 115 yards. You add the ability to catch the football in open space. That's tough to defend. 21.
He's 3 games into his sophomore year. He already has 7 100-yard rushing games. And boy, Garcia was stood up by Tawani. Jabari Tawani was waiting for him on the corner.
They say that Jabari Tawani might be the best defensive lineman ever at Navy. And that's saying a whole lot. He's a strong, good player, 265 pounds.
When the recruiters came calling and wanted him to transfer, he said, I've been through too much with these guys. I'm not going anywhere.
Maybe he's been doing the fire zone, dropping one guy into the middle of the field.
Garcia, plenty of time in the pocket, throws underneath to Cunningham. Cunningham across midfield inside the 49. That'll be enough for a first down. Justice Cunningham with his second catch of the year.
All right, so they do the fire zone again and they try to drop out 91. Watch right in here, this young man here. When he does, he jumps back, but he forgets to get the crossing line, the tight end. He's got to go over there, not just spy Stephen Garcia. Stephen Garcia wasn't planning on running, he was going to throw the ball.
Garcia takes off, then throws on the run. Cunningham cannot make the catch. Matt Warrick in coverage. Let's check in with Wendy.
Mike, thank you. Coming up on the Outback Steakhouse Halftime Report, a career day for Russell Wilson, which spelled good things for the Badgers. LaMichael James ran wild, and we'll have a preview of that primetime showdown in Tallahassee, Oklahoma at Florida State. We'll see you at the half.
Wendy will look forward to it. Garcia, after a horrible start, 8 out of 12 for 100 yards. Second and 10 for the Gamecocks. Lattimore lost his footing, and that cost him, picks up only 3 yards to the Navy 45.
Well, another third down opportunity for South Carolina. They're 3 of 4 on the night in conversions.
And one of the Navy defenders is down. If it's Warrick, they can ill afford to lose another linebacker. I mean, they're just running out of bodies.
Well, they had 3 coming into this game that didn't make it.
We'll check on him when we come back. We're tied at 14 in Columbia.
Tune in to an exciting new show, NFL 32, a highly interactive program driven by social media, where you, the fan, help decide the topics of the show. Join hosts Chris Mortensen, Susie Culver, and a rotating cast of ESPN analysts weekdays at 6 Eastern on ESPN2, NFL 32, where everyone has a voice.
1:32 to go, first half. South Carolina trying to break that tie. They have reached the Navy 45-yard line and face a third and long.
Well, Navy's been doing the deal where they dropped one of their linemen into the zone area just shy of the first down marker. Let's see if they go ahead and bring four this time.
South Carolina goes to a two tight end set. Garcia on the option, trying to get to the outside, nowhere to go. Boy, Navy did a great job of pursuing. Bri French, Trevez Bush all got over there, and Garcia didn't have a chance.
Watch the corner. They change it up at Navy. Buddy Green says, okay, the three-man rush has not been working. They changed it up. They put pressure and forced Garcia out of the pocket. An excellent job by Buddy Green and the Navy defense.
Now, if you're South Carolina and the clock is running, do you kick? I think they're going to let the clock run down as far as it can, then call timeout, then kick. Although, this would give you at least the option of thinking, hey, there's not that much time left. We can run that last play, 10, 12 seconds off the clock. We get a first down, we got a shot. Steve Spurrier's not going to miss a trick, and that's for sure.
This week on ESPN's Monday Night Football, second-year quarterback Sam Bradford leads the Rams into MetLife Stadium, where they'll face Eli Manning and the Giants. Rams-Giants on ESPN's Monday Night Football at 8:30 Eastern, and also streaming live on WatchESPN.com and the WatchESPN app. Coverage begins at 7 with Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's.
Really couldn't tell what kind of ball club the Giants had a week ago when they played the Redskins with so many guys hurt. So Steve Spurrier using that time to get the clock down to 24 seconds. And now he's going to go for it on fourth and long with Garcia, maybe set up a field goal. Throws it underneath to Cunningham. Cunningham will get the first down and is knocked out of bounds. Stops the clock at the 16-second mark.
A couple of things that does. Not only does it help move the ball in for a first down and for them a chance to do something with a couple of timeouts, but it also gives some confidence to Steven Garcia. You know, this guy has to finish strong to going into the second half. Now you've got a Navy defense. They've got to be, they have to come after Garcia. They can't sit back. It will prevent them from having success if they do.
South Carolina's place kicker, Wooten, with a very strong leg. Garcia over the middle, tipped and nearly intercepted. And Warwick, who was injured a few plays ago, got back in coverage and tipped it away. He's also their leading tackler, so they're thrilled to have Warwick back on the field.
Well, with only 10 seconds to go, I'm tempted to say swing the ball to the flat to Marcus Lattimore. Let him
never
get the ball.
A bad choice.
Put the ball in Lattimore's hands. Let him run the ball down 10, 15 yards. Get out of bounds. Call timeout. Whatever you have to do to give yourself a chance for three.
From here, it would be a field goal of well over 50 yards. They'll dump it to Lattimore in the middle. He gets to the 31. He's taken down. And South Carolina will stop the clock with 4 seconds to go. This will give them a shot at a field goal.
Now the middle of the field is where they've been dropping into fire zone. The Navy did a nice job of quickly coming up to slow down Lattimore.
Wooten has already kicked a 49-yard field goal this year. In fact, it's his only field goal opportunity of the season.
Been a good half, hasn't it?
It's been a great half.
South Carolina coaches, they were not surprised at the success that Navy's offense had. This offense came in averaging 400 yards a game on the ground. I'm not so certain, though, that other fans around here were expecting such a tough battle.
This will be a 48-yard try, and you saw the Navy coaches, they're probably going to call a timeout, try to freeze the kicker because they have
Navy.
One available.
I would think that if you play for Steve Spurrier, it'd be hard to ice you.
That's a great point.
You know what I'm talking about?
You talked about the perception of people. The South Carolina fans and fans anywhere else where Navy is scheduled to play might think, hey, we got a real shot, run-ups, a lot of big numbers. Coaches know this offense and the way they execute it, this is no fun.
Well, Ricky Dobbs is gone, their Heisman candidate last season. It's a new quarterback, Chris Proctor. But the coaches who watched the film, they see the execution. They knew it'd be a challenge.
48-yard field goal try. And it is good. Jay Wooten.
That's what a top 10 team does. Good job by Steve Spurrier of execution, taking advantage of an opportunity and then getting the three before half.
Got to give him the credit of taking the 20 seconds off the clock. Playing it exactly the way you ought to. Let's go down to Janine.
Coach, we knew Navy's option was going to be a little bit tricky for you. What would you like to see change in the second half defensively?
Well, we did stop them a couple times. I think it's been a game of four possessions for each team. So we need to stay out there offensively, though. We messed up, but finally got a field goal out of this, which was good. But anyway, they run a good little option stuff. Hopefully we can stop them some in the second half. But offensively, we should be moving the ball a little bit better than we are.
What went into your decision to do the onside kick?
Well, I called timeout. I thought we was going to do a little surprise. I didn't know they were going to line up like that. I mean, we lined up, just showed it, and they brought everybody up. But we still may do one if we have to somewhere.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you, Janine. Our halftime's... Welcome back to the SEC on ESPN, where the Gamecocks of South Carolina are leading the Navy midshipmen 17-14 at the half. Let's take a look at our expert breakdown brought to you by Farmers Insurance. Craig?
Mike, they call it the triple option for a reason. There are three different ways that you can go with the football. Chris Proctor's done an excellent job of distributing it where it's supposed to go. They got the pitch, the outside early on, the nice touchdown run. Then he gives it to the quarterback, keeps it himself, gets in the end zone for the touchdown. It's time for Alexander Teach, the fullback, to do his thing. The balance of this offense in the first half was a problem for South Carolina. They were to the left, they were the right, they had enough up the middle to gain the respect and keep the respect on the inside of South Carolina's defense. Now, I think that the South Carolina defense, as the game went on in the second quarter, started to feel it a little more, started to be a little more physical and use their athletic ability.
Janine Edwards working the sidelines for us. She worked the game in Toledo last night. Janine, we're keeping you busy, aren't we?
Yeah, really, still on the move. And I just caught up with Navy head coach Ken Niumatalolo, who told me, I feel really good with where we're at. He said, I really like the way we're moving the ball. He said, yes, we did have a few missed opportunities, but hey, we're playing against a few first-round draft picks. He said, if we can keep executing in this second half, and if we can possibly get ahead by a score, I'd be very happy. And Mike, don't forget, Navy scored first, and under this coach, they are 24-2 when they score first.
Those are pretty good numbers. That'll help at the halftime speech. Navy will kick it off to start the second half.
This formation on the kickoff, and the reason they huddle up like that is so that the defense can't really identify who the L1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 is on either side. They have to hope that they can get to the right guy and have an assignment as they go down the field.
Teague to kick. Ellington is deep. He'll bring it out from 3 yards in the end zone. And there's a collision and the ball came out. There's also a flag down. And South Carolina got it back. Now we'll check the marker. And it will go against the Gamecocks. What do you expect from Marcus Lattimore?
Illegal block in the back, number 21. The penalty is half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul. First down.
What do you expect from Marcus Lattimore in the second half? Well, in his last three quarters, he's rushed for 212 yards, and that's the ball coming loose. South Carolina fortunate to get it back.
Well, they sure were. And the one thing that I do expect out of Lattimore is more of the same. That's error-free football, moving the chains.
Lattimore offset to the right of Steven Garcia. And he'll get the call. And the tackling machine, Matt Warrick, is there to bring him down.
Again, coming into this game, Navy had three linebackers that didn't make the trip, couldn't play. So they've had to juggle the bodies that they have. They're playing a lot lighter than they would want to. So it's a speed game against the power of Marcus Lattimore.
Garcia will keep it himself. Across the 20 to about the 22, and that's good enough for a first down.
This is what we showed you in the James game, the EA sports stuff earlier. This is a powerful asset to have. You fake it to Lattimore, everyone goes to him, then he turns into a blocker. And the ability to run the ball by Garcia, he's a big, strong guy. He's got good vision. He's got some power.
But it's really funny, after you watch Lattimore
run, start, 87 offense, 5 yards.
And then you see Garcia run, it looks like he's running in slow motion. No offense to Garcia, but that's how good Lattimore is.
Every offense wants to come out of the locker room and have perfection. They don't want to come out with a penalty on the kick return and having a procedure penalty. They want to come out and be perfect. This is not a good start to the second half.
First and 15, Lattimore off the right side. Warrick has him, but Lattimore drags him across the 25 to the 27-yard line.
And for this football team, ranked 10th in the country, yet with a lot of things they need to improve on as a ball club, winning this football game, whether it's by 1 point or 50 points, is paramount, because that will let them get back to conventional football teams that they're going against and not have to deal with these triple option offenses.
The National Freshman of the Year a season ago has obviously gotten better for his sophomore campaign, and he's got a first down here up to the 39-yard line. The middle guard, Jared Marks, made the tackle. 16 carries, 140 yards for Lattimore. His average, 144 coming in, and we've just started the second half.
Again, going back to this defense, three on the defensive line and the four linebackers across. It's that soft bubble that Lattimore's having so much success for. They're trying to walk one up to make it a four-man line, but it's not been successful.
Garcia after play action and throws complete and finally got it to Alshon Jeffrey, a Biletnikoff finalist a year ago who had 88 catches for 1,517 yards.
Now, when you get outside coverage one-on-one with Alshon Jeffries, not many will be able to cover him. Worked his way back to the ball. Garcia confident in throwing it, at least to Jeffries. You're going to get someone goes up who fights for the football. Remember early in this ball game when Navy did come with 4-5 on the pass rush, it gave them a chance to move Garcia.
Lattimore inside the 30. Dalton Wilson, the fullback, cleared the way for him. A gain of 20.
That Dalton Wilson you're talking about is a walk-on who came out here and has earned the respect through his performance. Marcus Lattimore is just a workhorse. There's no other way to explain it. He just methodically goes about his business. And keep this in mind. As the game goes on, defenses get tired, he gets stronger.
If you got the big hoss, you ride him. Lattimore this time. Tawani spun him down.
I guess when I say that Navy's defense has had success when they bring more than expected, it's been successful. It's a slow death what you have now, which Buddy Green's okay with as long as they can find a way to make them try to kick three instead of getting six. But at some point, you're going to have to roll the dice a little bit there.
Garcia, a little flanker screen out to Jason Barnes. And Barnes with enough yardage for a third and two situation.
Third down has been such an important part of this football game for both teams. Neither one can stop the other.
Barnes so far, four catches, 47 yards. Lattimore lost his balance, cut it back. He should have the first down at the 18-yard line. Needed to get just inside the 19 to move the chains. With him, that's about all you can hope for is that he slips after he gets the handoff.
He doesn't slip very often. Like I said, when you watch him run, his pads are always out front. He's not cutting on the back two cleats of his heel. He's using those front four.
Garcia looking towards Steve Spurrier. First down, Gamecocks. They're up by three and driving in the third quarter. Garcia pump fake under pressure. Floats it up and it's intercepted. And that has been the bane of Steven Garcia throughout his career. The big mistake. Quasi Mitchell was waiting for the wounded duck of a pass and got it inside the five.
Once again, Buddy Green changes the look. He comes with a blitz. The blitz has worked on passing situations against Garcia. Made him just throw the football up. That's what drives Coach Steve Spurrier crazy. I imagine the next time the old ball coach will be handing it to number 21.
3-point ball game here in South Carolina. Welcome back to ESPN's coverage of college football presented by Miller Lite. Now, if you're Navy, you're thinking, what would a 91-yard drive do for us right now?
It let their defense rest, for one. For two, it certainly put the pressure on South Carolina's team.
Quarterback keeper. And he pays the price. A shot by Melvin Ingram right in the grill of Chris Proctor.
Well, let's talk about the grill here on that interception. South Carolina's offensive line has to do a better job. Their guard and center just fell to the ground, hit no one. You know, so you can't place it all on Garcia's shoulders.
But how do you make that throw?
You can't get away from it, can you?
Oh.
Buddy Green hasn't blitzed three, four, five times this game, but the majority of them have been successful.
Teach tripped up as he reached the 18-yard line. This is going to bring up a third and short for the midshipmen.
Now they're 5 of 7 on the night. The South Carolina defense coming in just couldn't stop teams, allowing 45% conversion. That trend, that poor trend's continued.
They hurry back to the line.
Mike, the last time that they had the 4th and 1 and they didn't make it, remember the midline quarterback? Maybe go back, give it to Teich in the middle. Give it to Teach, let him run.
It's the last time Proctor tried to keep it and didn't make it. He'll keep it again, and he will make it this time just barely across the 20-yard line, which is all he needed. Chris Proctor had to win an ongoing argument with his mother just to go to the Naval Academy. She was against the 5-year military commitment. And then he had to sit behind Ricky Dobbs all those years and watch Dobbs rewrite the record book for Navy. But this is Chris Proctor's time. He is the starter for the Naval Academy in his senior season. He's already won 2 games. What can he do in this one?
I can tell you what might happen here in this third quarter. Play action pass.
Teach only a couple. Janine Edwards, what do you have?
And Mike, you and Craig have been talking about South Carolina's lack of stopping ability on Navy's third downs. And I was overhearing some of the defensive backs for South Carolina a little while ago talking about how confusing this option offense is. They say they're trying to follow the quarterback, and the quarterback is just tricking them with where the ball ends up going. They were just saying it's just so hard to read.
And they only have the 1 week to get ready for it. They don't see it any other time of the year. It is just a nightmare for a coaching staff to play a team that is so good at this kind of triple option offense. Somehow, Proctor got out of there and threw it away. There is a flag down in the secondary.
Prior to the snap, delay a gain, offense, 5 yards, still second down.
Well, this team just doesn't make mistakes in the penalty category. When you look at what they do, it's usually, if not the best, at least second. So they just don't make mistakes. And on a play action pass like that right there, it got them out of the norm, out of their character. So you can see how someone tried to do something a little different before the snap.
An unfavorable down and distance for Navy. Second and 12. Want a screen back to the other side. They get it to John O'Boyle, who makes his first catch of the season. Don't get much out of it, though, because Kelsey Quarles was there.
Devin Taylor, very talented big man. Watch him running. Look at the movement, getting back outside to the open field. Watch the speed getting to the ball.
Taylor, with 8 tackles, leads the South Carolina defense. Third and 10 for Navy. Proctor chased, throws on a run, has a man wide open at midfield. Bo Snelson somehow on third and 10. There wasn't a soul within 5 yards of him.
He's the A-back and he's on the right side. Watch when he goes in motion. He's the motion back A going across. You see him there moving from your right to your left, and no one finds him. South Carolina's linebackers just couldn't find him, and he got down the field. And, you know, that's one of those big, big plays to lift up an offense that was about to get in trouble.
That is a gain of 34 on probably the least favorite down and distance they're ever going to get, third and long, which for them is often a running down.
And then to come right back in a hurry-up mode to pick up 7 yards on first down.
Teach, straight up the middle. Teach fumbles the ball. Still loose, and Navy appeared to get it back inside the 10. Oh, what a break for the midshipman. Teach with a great run, but then he coughed it up. Howell got it back at the end.
Alexander Teach, this is the finesse part of his game. You see the footwork that he has there? He had 2 hands on the ball. He just got hit with a helmet right to the football, and then fortunately for Navy, down around it. Multiple white shirts to go down to help save that play and keep it from being a disaster.
Antonio Allen was the man who knocked it loose, but South Carolina couldn't come up with it. Proctor inside the 5.
3 times now we've seen the spin move and the acceleration of Chris Proctor. Ken Niumatalolo, the head coach, said he's the fastest quarterback he's ever had. It's probably the fastest that's ever been at Navy, certainly on this team. And that kind of speed, you got to have it if you're going to try to run away from South Carolina, who's really fast.
Second and goal.
At quarterback midline, faking into the fullback inside and then following him up in there.
The fullback is Diggs as Teach gets a breather. Diggs inside the 2.
South Carolina's interior defense has to get back on it. They had began to establish control on the inside in the second quarter. Kind of got away from that. But that's the patience of Navy's offense. Week in and week out, they're methodical 2 yards, 3 yards, 8 yards, 12 yards.
Teach Proctor and Green each have better than 50 yards in this game. Third and goal from the two. Fullback, touchdown, Alexander Teach. Teach almost never attended the Naval Academy. He had a thumb injury when he was at their prep school in Newport, Rhode Island. Decided to leave because he was homesick. 30 to 40 of his teammates surrounded him after taps and said, "You're not going anywhere. You're going to come to the Naval Academy." Hasn't regretted it 1 minute since then. 11 plays, 91 yards, 6 minutes and 10 seconds.
91 yards. You asked the question, didn't you? As they got the football, what would this mean? I tell you what this means. South Carolina's offense better come out and answer the bell. Their defense needs some help.
ESPN's College Football Primetime, brought to you by Dr. Pepper. With 23 flavors, Dr. Pepper is always one of a kind. And the U.S. Postal Service.
The head ball coach has had quite a career, starting with the Tampa Bay Bandits of the USFL in 1983. Won six SEC titles, a national championship in Florida, now in his seventh year at South Carolina. He was as intense a competitor as you would ever see, both as a player and a coach. And when he won the Heisman Trophy in 1966, it was well deserved. He was a brilliant quarterback at the University of Florida. And I just love to listen to him talk.
I sure enjoy visiting with him. He's a player. He's a guy that understands what it takes to be successful, how you prepare to have success, and he's been fantastic for South Carolina.
Gamecocks in a hole. Gilmore, the corner, runs into a piled Navy tacklers at the 20-yard line. We've got a timeout, 3:26 to go, third quarter. Navy leads.
Sunday mornings on ESPN and ESPN2 have new looks. On ESPN, Sunday NFL Countdown, presented by IBM, has expanded to 3 hours and now begins at 10 Eastern. And on ESPN2, your favorite Sunday morning shows, starting with Outside the Lines, then the Sports Reporters, Sports Center, then a little fantasy football.
They are starting to get a little nervous in Columbia, South Carolina. And they're getting ready to party if you're wearing white Naval Academy uniforms. Garcia, play action. Dumps it to Lattimore. Makes a couple of guys miss. Picks up five. Check in with Wendy Nix. Wendy.
Mike, thank you. It's a rematch of the 2003 Fiesta Bowl. Ja'Cory Harris back from suspension and making the start. Here to Allen Harris for 3 yards and the score. And Miami up 14-0 over the Buckeyes from Ohio State. Texas A&M, by the way, shutting out Idaho 17-0.
Well, Ohio State has certainly had better years, haven't they?
Did they say 14-0 Miami?
Yes.
So they get Ja'Cory Harris back and Sean Spence, their linebacker. You know, what an unbelievable job that team and that place, that program has done of staying on track.
Absolutely. Second call at 6 for South Carolina, trying to respond after that touchdown march by Navy. And they'll be about a yard shy of a first down after Lattimore runs that one out. Let's check in with Janine.
Well, Mike, when the Navy defense was last on the field and they came up with that huge interception, the D-line coaches sat them down and said, "Guys, this is why we keep playing up front. You just never know." And even though defensive coordinator Buddy Green told us he thought his line was outweighed by South Carolina's by about 60 pounds, he said, "Guys, we've got to just keep bringing that pressure off the edge. That's what's going to help us."
Boy, Janine, Lattimore just got that on his own.
He didn't
actually hit behind the line of scrimmage. He's got 21 carries, Craig, 171 yards.
Absolutely, man. And to Janine's point and Buddy Green, man, it is so true. Their defense just play to the whistle, beyond the whistle, the shadow of the whistle.
Lattimore again. You know, I think if it were humanly possible to give a running back the ball 50 times and have him be able to play next week and the week after that. Lattimore, get it. I'd give it to him 50 times.
Steve Spurrier said it's hard not to put it in his hands.
Yeah.
You know, and I do believe that he does get stronger, proven by watching the guy. Fourth quarter's his quarter.
Well, certainly he doesn't get any weaker and everybody else tires out. Garcia with a quick out to Jones. And Jones very close to the sticks.
Redshirt freshman Nick Jones, this offense, it can't just be Marcus Lattimore, though. I mean, to win this conference, you've got to have some balance. They have to get Steven Garcia in a rhythm to where he can take advantage of it. Alshon Jeffries is an All-American. He's got to touch the football. He has to be successful as well.
Well, Steve Spurrier said, you know, our receivers get a lot of publicity and everything, but they got to start doing something. Garcia's going to be forced to throw it away. A rare opportunity for Navy to chase the passer. And the crowd is cheering for the fact that Garcia threw it away instead of taking the sack or throwing an interception.
Well, he was looking over, and there's a safety over the top that you won't see in this shot here. Corner underneath on him and a safety over the top. Jeffries, he breaks up off of his route. But, I mean, they know on defense, Navy does, where number one is.
I don't know what they call it anymore. It used to be known as the Bronx cheer. Four-man rush. Garcia with time throws again to Jones. And Jones will pick up another first down to the 44-yard line.
Now, this is good here. You know, Garcia throw it away. He's heard the boos. If you're a quarterback in the SEC, beyond that, if
or
you
anywhere
play for
else.
Steve Spurrier, you've heard more than the boos. And so he's got a strong, thick back. He can handle the pressure of that. Be methodical. Don't panic. Get your offense down the field.
First and 10 just inside the 45. Lattimore on the delay. Well, he's just 5 or 6 yards downfield before somebody puts any pads on him.
Well, I'm going to show you why. Again, look at the depth of these linebackers. Those big bubbles. That's a void. I'm sitting here and I told the producer, Scott Matthews, on the talkback before the ball was snapped. Here comes the run. They're giving you 5 or 6 yards with that defense.
Craig, do you think it's because they're afraid of the pass?
They're respectful and mindful of both.
Lattimore just dragging bodies with him inside the 30. Another first down. South Carolina on the move as the third quarter comes to a close. They have given up the lead. They'll try to get it back when we return to Columbia for the fourth quarter. The name of that song is Blood Pressure. Can you imagine being a coach where those readings have to be in the middle of a ball game like this? Break the pressure cuff.
They're the number 10 team in the country, and as they enter the fourth quarter, they're at home, SEC country. Expect them to bring it in the fourth quarter.
An update on Marcus Lattimore. He's working on a career high, which is 212 yards, set against Florida last year. He's already at 191. Oops. 9.5 more. Here's Wendy Nix.
Thank you, Mike. Here's what's going on across our ESPN networks. Miami up 14-0 over Ohio State on ESPN, and the showdown of them all, Oklahoma and Florida State still scoreless on ABC, 8:47 to go in the first quarter.
All right, Wendy, thanks. The clock at 14:47 here. They're going to measure for a first down, and it is 10 yards for Lattimore. 200 yards rushing. Doesn't even look winded, does he?
He's just ready. Last week, 176 yards on 27 carries against Georgia. He's ready. He's got his stamina built up.
A lot of that came in the fourth quarter when they absolutely had to have it. This time, he's bottled up, and he's only going to get maybe 3 yards out of it.
Remember now, the last time that South Carolina got down in the red zone is when Buddy Green brought the blitz. And Steven Garcia threw the ball up in the air for an interception. And what did we say going to break on that? The next time they get down here, they're going to give it to number 21.
And then they're going to give it to number 21. And then Lattimore pounds his way inside the 10, right at the chains again. Just shy of a first down. Lattimore, Navy rises up and stopped him inside the 10. Short of the 9, it is not going to be a first down and will bring up an interesting decision.
Well, I'd ask for there to be a measurement to give number 21 a breather. No question about it. And then I'd run it on fourth down again to Marcus Lattimore.
No thought of a field goal here, would you?
You've got Marcus Lattimore back there. You're going to give it to him. And this breather right here, take as long as you want to stretch those chains out. Spurrier's thinking.
Well, Navy stopped him on third down. Can they stop him on fourth? Of course, there is a with a play caller like Spurrier who loves to cross people up. The thought of faking it to him and throwing the ball has got to be at least in the back of his mind.
There's no doubt about that. But if you're Navy, you have to go all out. You have to concede one or the other. You got to go 12 guys against the run. And if he happens to pull out with play action, then so be it.
Garcia will keep it and appears to have plenty for the first down.
That's a nice job of Spurrier coaching, man. That wedge, that offensive line up front.
Moved him out, didn't they?
And you saw 21 behind him, Lattimore. If he needed to get up there and help the pile move a little bit more, that was going to be an added 230 pounds to the game.
As we approach the 13-minute mark, first and goal, South Carolina. Lattimore back in the eye behind his fullback, Dalton Wilson, number 46. Another big dose of number 21. You betcha. Lattimore, touchdown. He just set a personal record, a school record, 212 yards and 3 touchdowns in this game. Is he any good or what? I remember seeing him in his first game last year going, oh boy, did they find a great player.
And he's humble. You know, if he weren't a quiet guy, he would be the vocal leader of this ball club.
What is not to like? Marcus Lattimore gives South Carolina the lead again. It is a madhouse in Columbia, South Carolina. Welcome back to the SEC on ESPN. These teams have just traded methodical 91-yard touchdown drives, and it is a 3-point lead for South Carolina over Navy. Marcus Thomas is deep. Up to the 25-yard line before he is thrown back. Let's take a look at our FaceTime profile brought to you by Edward Jones. Roger Staubach, 62-64 at Navy, 3,571 career passing yards. He had 18 touchdowns, won the Heisman Navy one of four schools with a president and a Super Bowl winning quarterback. And that would have been Jimmy Carter, the nuclear engineer. Roger Staubach went on to become one of the most successful businessmen in the country in real estate. Teach. Stacked up at the line of scrimmage, Melvin Ingram, injured earlier, made the tackle. Here's Wendy.
Mike, thank you. We go back to Tallahassee for SportsCenter right now. Oklahoma on the board, courtesy of Landry Jones and a one-yard touchdown plunge. Sooners up 7-0. And in baseball, Mariano Rivera ties the Major League saves record, earning the 601st of his career and trying Trevor Hoffman.
Chris Proctor forced out of the pocket. Taken down at around the 27-yard line. That's going to bring up a very tough distance for Navy, third and long.
Now getting it to second and 10 was a real plus. Is why they were able to force Navy to do something different, which is out of character, and that's throwing the ball. But in this ball game on third downs, they've been 8 of 10 tonight. But they haven't been third and 7. They've been third and 4 and 2.
Exactly. Teach is the fullback. Howell is the split back. And Proctor's going to have to use the timeout. He was trying to change the play. Because of the noise, he was going up and down the line of scrimmage trying to tell his linemen individually and just ran out of time. 11 minutes, 28 seconds to go, and a beauty from Columbia, South Carolina. Welcome back to ESPN's coverage of college football presented by Miller Lite. It is a four-point ball game. They've done it before on third down, Craig.
Yeah, and the key has been that it's been by way of air. The nice throws that Proctor's made. And what did you notice in that? His legs. South Carolina is going to be in a nickel defense, five defensive backs. If you try to run the option, they could come up and support that. I think he needs to create a way to make a play with his legs.
Third and long, trying to get outside, and South Carolina says nothing doing. He'll lose a couple. Well, they defended that as well as they have defended anything all night long. Hawk and Swearinger in on the tackle, a loss of two.
Yes, they come in and they pin him and they try to say, look, Proctor, you're going to stay inside the tackles. We're not going to let you get to the outside. And now you're seeing the speed of South Carolina's defense come to play for them.
So Navy's going to have to kick it away with Pablo Beltran. And South Carolina is going to burn a timeout.
The chase for the Sprint Cup begins with Jimmy Johnson eyeing his sixth straight title, while regular season points leader Kyle Busch and four-time NASCAR champion Jeff Gordon look to knock him off. The chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup starts with the Geico 400 at Chicago. Coverage begins tomorrow at 1 Eastern on ESPN with NASCAR Countdown presented by NAPA.
You know, I know I've got a sore throat, and that's why you're reading the promos, but you have done it so well. I think we found a new tradition here.
I think not. I admire listening to you. You have the best pipes in the business. I'm going to take care of the old lungs for next week.
I didn't think it would work, but it was worth a shot. Ace Sanders, who already has a 68-yard return for a touchdown this year, waits at his 45. Nice high sailing punt goes out of bounds. That'll cut the distance off. They'll mark it closer to midfield. Marcus Lattimore resumes his Heisman campaign as the Gamecock offense takes the field after this. Designated as a National Historic Landmark in 1976. This guy may have a statue built for him one of these days.
And it'll have a stiff arm coming from it.
And maybe a Heisman Trophy hanging from its arm. South Carolina would love to put Navy away right here. And that'll be up to Lattimore. And he is nailed as he got to the line of scrimmage. Bri French, the backup outside linebacker, does his job again. Here's Wendy.
Mike, thank you. Alabama took care of Penn State last Saturday at Happy Valley. Back home this week to host North Texas. So far, so good. Eddie Lacy on the 43-yard carry. 20-0 tied. 4:19 to play in the half. And Arkansas over Troy, 24-0.
All right, Wendy, 30 carries, 216 yards from Marcus Lattimore. Now he makes a catch and reaches the Navy 46-yard line. Should be enough for a first down.
These type of plays, when the pro scouts evaluate Marcus Lattimore, will bump him way up the ladder. Being able to catch and run. And a beautifully thrown ball by Steven Garcia out front. Let him keep continue the path up the field.
And that throw is not as easy as it looks.
Not at all.
First down, South Carolina. Only the second time tonight, Alshon Jeffrey makes the catch. Nice block by Cunningham, the tight end, to free him.
So quietly, the number 10 team in the country is trying to take control of this ball game. And Garcia, 17 of 24 now throwing. And if you can just feel it, right?
Navy's got to find a way to hold them to a field goal. I think that's the only shot they've got.
Well, and by doing that, you're going to have to take some chances on defense, which they've done from time to time tonight and been successful with it. You're going to have to mix it up or they'll absolutely mow you down.
Lattimore to the 20, picks up almost six. Here's Janine Edwards.
Well, Mike, you guys have talked about Lattimore being a workhorse, and I can tell you, when he came off the field after their last offensive series, the guy never sat down, not once. He did not take a drink of anything. He was walking the sideline. He hung with the defense for a little bit. He was pumping up the crowd. The guy has unlimited energy, and he's still going.
Janine, in terms of durability, he reminds me so much of Marshall Faulk when he was at San Diego State. We did one game where he carried the ball 46, 47 times. We're walking off the field after the game, and he'd gained over 300 yards. He still wasn't breathing hard.
And, well, Steve Spurrier was telling us yesterday that after last week's game, he was the first one back on Sunday morning for a little ice, extra workout, weights. I mean, he takes care of his body.
And you don't think that opens up his teammates' eyes? Looked like Lattimore moved early there, and South Carolina may have gotten a break.
Yeah, he went Canada on that one.
Yeah. Got that little half step, and there is a flag.
Illegal motion, number 21, 5 yards, previous spot. Still first down.
Well, it just proved he's human. He did something that wasn't correct tonight.
Yeah, I guess it's okay for him to make him go backwards 5 yards. Yeah, he just got the lean going there. The timing was off. You see the linebacker level, though, of Navy? They've got that big bubble, and I'm glad that I saw that, because what needs to happen if the linebackers are playing soft? You got to come down the hill. When you see run, you got to come meet it immediately. But when you've got big linemen up in front of you, they're going to come get you before you get up. You're running back.
Garcia throws to Cunningham on the run, and Cunningham lost the ball out of bounds. They're going to mark it at the 8-yard line.
See if he had possession. Known more as a blocking tight end than a receiving tight end. Oh, yeah, he was up the field, possession running. Ball fumbled out of bounds.
They need to get to the 3-yard line for a first down, so it will be second and 5.
Well, knowing that Navy doesn't have a passing game, 7 points here would be really hard on them.
Lattimore just pushes the pile close to the 5-yard line. And at this point, if you're the Naval Academy on third down and 2 coming, you're going to have to sell out.
Yeah, because, again, just knowing, understanding the game. Chris Proctor is good at throwing when he's in rhythm within the game. But not, he's not a drop back. This isn't a drop back offense.
Clock ticking away.
Last time we saw them down here, It was the I formation, and it was Marcus Lattimore over the left side. See what happens here.
They need two on third down. And flags again. It looked like the right tackle, Rokevious Watkins, moved early.
Offense, number 73, 5 yards. Still third down.
Now there's a big difference. Third and two, now it's third and seven.
Yeah, you've had two mental mistakes by this offense on this series here. They've got to hold their water. They have to be patient. They've got to be better than that. And a championship team doesn't make mistakes like that. When they feel someone on the ropes, they go punch them.
Now, does this change your thoughts of a play call? Or do you still want to give it to Lattimore?
Well, I still want to give it to Lattimore, but I also know to the left side at the top of your screen is Alshon Jeffrey as well.
Lattimore up the middle. He is going to be shy of a first down, back to the 5 yard line. So it will be fourth and two. Decision time for South Carolina.
Yeah, I think they go for it here because they do not want to give the ball back to Navy up by six. That Navy offense has all the ability in the world. We've seen them go 91 yards tonight. Plenty of time at 6 minutes for them.
I think it's the correct decision, too.
Absolutely. You got to protect yourself with this.
Ball game's on the line here, fourth and two.
I think Lattimore's saying maybe going over the top on this thing. I don't know. That's a long ways. I'd stay on the ground, young man. I'd go strong.
He's the deep man in the eye. Lattimore on the toss, and they got him behind the line. Holy cow, what a stand by Navy. Wes Henderson, number 99, diagnosed the play and made the tackle. Holy cow, what a play.
You know, I talked about a while ago getting down the line of scrimmage or going down the hill. This play here, a beautiful job of Henderson, 6'2", 250. Can move and have the power at 250 pounds to bring him down.
My, oh my. 5 minutes and 34 seconds to go. Navy starting another drive. Teach out to the eight. Rodney Polk made the tackle.
We have not seen the option game to the outside in quite a while in this football game. But early on, the option worked for the long touchdown that was done by John Howell. See if we can watch and find Navy getting to the outside with the option game.
Proctor dragged down just shy of the 10. It will be third and about one for Navy. Now, even if you run the hurry up in this offense, you still burn a lot of time because it's nothing but running plays.
Now, but this is the area where they've been so successful tonight on third downs. They were
8 out of 11.
Now it's 8 of 11, but the last one that they went for was third and seven. Not manageable.
Proctor on the keep. He's got the first down to the 20.
Working to the outside, getting back on the perimeter. South Carolina's interior has taken control through this ball game, so they've now got to get back to the outside. And one thing that Niematalola told us was knowing what to do with the ball, making the right decisions with the ball is the specialty of Chris Proctor.
Proctor hit this time in the backfield. He's going to lose four. Jadeveon Clowney, the number one recruit in the entire country.
Big fella coming through.
Oh.
Had one responsibility, that was the quarterback. He went to the quarterback, didn't look at the fullback. Did you notice that as a true freshman? Had he peeked inside at that fullback just a little bit, Proctor would have gotten around him.
He is 6'6", 254 with an unlimited future. Proctor on the toss to G.G. Green, and G.G. Green will be stopped shy of the original line of scrimmage, and Clowney makes the stop again.
South Carolina secondary has picked it up. Now they understand a lot better where the ball is going to go. They are forcing the pitch by getting up the field with the end man on the line of scrimmage, and they're starting to fill that alley out there so that the ball carrier can't get around it.
Third and 12, for the most part, uncharted territory for Navy. And the noise is a factor. Sumrall, the left tackle, jumps.
The 76 offense, 5 yards, still third down.
Two of the three penalties tonight have been on passing situations. Out of character for Navy. Trying to get down the field a little quick. Trying to get to the next level. Trying to get something, maybe do something you're not supposed to do.
Third and 17. Proctor wants a screen. Teach back to the 16, and that's it. Well diagnosed by that South Carolina defense. Rodney Paulk was the first one to sniff it out. He was out in the flat.
Well, I think here's reality for Ken Niumatalolo. If you punt the ball back to South Carolina,
game's over.
Game's over. You know, because you can't stop them with just two timeouts.
You're right. Fourth and 15, and they're going to go for it. Some people are going to criticize this call. I think it's the only thing he can do. Clowney is chasing him. The throw caught. It's going to be a first down. Are you kidding? Matt Aiken. Proctor is running to his right, throws back against his body, somehow got it there.
Now this is a unique, great call because it's rolling to the right for a left-handed quarterback. Great pressure from Clowney coming from behind, but once again the speed of Proctor opened up and allowed the play to happen.
What a play on fourth down, and Teach moves the pile out to the 34. But look at the clock. We're down to 1:41. Like I said, this offense, even if you're in a hurry up, takes forever.
In the huddle, South Carolina's defense has to remind themselves, don't let your eyes watch the quarterback. You've got a responsibility, stay with it, especially on the perimeter.
Proctor throws, and G.G. Green was the intended target, never got his head around. And the ball fell harmlessly behind him, and he had a seam between the two safeties.
There's usually a seam in the play action of this offense because of the safeties trying to get to their responsibility. The ball thrown a little bit too quick, but you're also taught as a receiver, when you get beyond linebacker level, get your head around, find the football.
Another huge down for Navy. Third and about seven. Proctor under pressure from Clowney, got away. Still keeping the play alive and throws it out of bounds. Clowney is an unbelievable physical specimen at 6'6", 254.
Number
As you
seven.
Might expect, he dominated people in high school.
He said he needed to work on using his hands and using his arms to get rid of people. He got rid of about three folks on that one right there and then got back and got over in the action.
He's going to be a monster.
Another monster in the SEC in the making.
Another huge fourth down. Can Navy keep it going? Proctor over the middle. This one is going to be intercepted by Allen. Antonio Allen with the pick in the 45-yard line. His second interception.
At some point, you just know that you can't pull another rabbit out of the hat. This is not a passing offense. Time to throw the ball. But this secondary, this team, this defense, bending, not breaking, making a play when they have to, taking advantage of a throw that probably shouldn't have been thrown.
Boy, what an effort by Navy.
And, Mike, this is a game South Carolina and their coaching staff will be glad is over, glad they got the win. They'll get back to the basics. Ellis Johnson will start coaching a little bit more on defense.
Absolutely.
And, man, those conventional offenses are going to seem a little easier, aren't they?
Well, this one gave them fits. 54 seconds left. We'll be back after this. Welcome back to the SEC on ESPN.
Tune in to an exciting new show, NFL 32, a highly interactive program driven by social media, where you, the fan, help decide the topics of the show. I like that concept, Mike. Oh, it's pretty nice. Join host Chris Mortensen, Susie Culver, and a rotating cast of ESPN analysts weekdays at 6 Eastern on ESPN2, NFL 32, where everyone has a voice, including you, Mike Patrick.
We have created a monster. Now he's ad-libbing the promos.
But see, an analyst can do that.
Oh, I guess you can. You have that built into your contract, don't you?
No, that's a very, very shaky line in my contract.
Marcus Lattimore, 36 carries, 240 yards. And counting. My heavens, what a player. But South Carolina is going to know they have been in a fist fight, and they're not going to want to see any more of Navy. We're down to 46 seconds. Marcus Lattimore with another brilliant performance. Welcome back to ESPN's coverage of college football presented by Miller Lite, 24-21 South Carolina. Here's Janine Edwards.
Well, Mike, you know, the old ball coach is known as a brilliant offensive mind, and he's been known to seek every edge, and maybe that's why he has used 23 quarterbacks over the last 24 seasons. Very crafty. Well, you know, there's another Spurrier around as well. This one's a lean, mean racing machine, and guys, he has used 7 different jockeys in the last 9 races. I'm sensing a trend here. Is that crafty, or is that out of frustration by his trainer, Bob Baffert? Well, we'll never know, but the coach, Spurrier, has Spurrier's picture in his office.
Janine, that's terrific. There are two guys that I want to mention on the Navy football team as they're going to be able to run out the clock. One is the third-string fullback. His name is Mike Patrick. He is far more talented than the name would lead you to believe. And I also want to mention a Navy special teamer and a third string safety who has the best name I have ever heard. And I've been doing college football for a long time. His name is Wave Ryder. W-A-V-E Ryder. He is from Hawaii. And I would like to meet his parents.
His teammate rode the wave all right tonight.
Yes, they did. Boy, huge, huge ball game for the Gamecocks of South Carolina. They remain undefeated, and we got to see everything we needed out of Marcus Lattimore. Once again, the final score, 24-21. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Craig James, Janine Edwards, and our entire crew, this is Mike Patrick. Good night from Columbia, South Carolina. Here's Wendy Nix.